Footballers' contracts are filled with clauses. Assists, goal, and clean sheet bonuses are just a few examples. But some players require special treatment, like needing to be told, no, you can't go to outer space. The No Space Travel Clause. In 1999, Sunderland signed Swedish Player of the Year, Stefan Schwartz from Valencia. And they had to specify he was not allowed to go into space. It's true, I'd love to go into space. My agent said, let's get this contract won, and we'll go. But then Sunderland heard about it. The Visiting Friends Clause. FC Barcelona's negotiators had to work their magic to sign Neymar from Santos. Money aside, I mean, a shit ton of money aside, Neymar had special requests. The Toys, his entourage, had to be flown out to Barcelona every 2 weeks at the expense of the club. PSG took the quick route and just put them on the payroll. Good idea. No wonder Neymar's level has dropped when he's constantly surrounded by his gang. The No Biting Clause. Luis Hannibal Suarez's odd ways were not a fit for Barcelona's image. The number one problem was his strange eating habits. The Catalan club added a clause in Suarez's contract forbidding him from biting rivals. But Suarez soon changed his diet and found his best form. The Sheep's Testicle Clause. Speaking of food, Spencer Pryor was invited to feast upon signing with Cardiff City. Before letting the defender play for his team, the club owner imposed one condition: eat a Lebanese delicacy. Sheep's testicles. That's right, I said sheep's testicles. It was a test of character, a symbol of trust, and Pryor passed. The No-Fly Clause. The only thing that could stop Dennis Bergkamp was an airplane. His crippling fear of flying was taken into account in his Arsenal contract, and he was never asked to fly. That's why he missed key games. And by the way, speaking of planes, when Samuel Eto'o signed with Russian side NC Makhachkala, he decided that he preferred living in Moscow, a mere 1,200 miles away. So he made sure a private jet was thrown in on top of his $26 million a year contract. The Lego House Clause. When Giuseppe Reina signed for Arminia Bielefeld, he thought he was the best negotiator in the world. Wages aside, he demanded a new house be built for him every season. So imagine his shock when the club's directors gave him a house. Yep, made out of Lego bricks. The Good Conduct Clause. Balotelli to Liverpool was an odd move. The Reds knew this and wanted to ensure Crazy Mario would be on his best behavior. If he followed a code of conduct, he would earn an extra $1.3 million. If he's not dismissed from the field 3 times or more for violent conduct, spitting at an opponent, using offensive language or gestures, well, you can just imagine how that went. The Anti-PSG Clause. 2012 was expected to be the end of the world, but ended up being Paul Pogba's best season ever. Juventus were quick to renew his contract amid transfer rumors. His $70 million transfer clause had an extra condition. If your name is PSG, you have to pay an extra $10 million. Juve just wanted Pogba not to even think about a Paris move. Similar to this, Roberto Firmino's release clause is over $100 million, unless it's Arsenal. The Ballon d'Or Clause. Great things were expected from Angel Di Maria when he moved to Manchester United. So much so that Real Madrid negotiated an extra payment of $6.5 million. If Di Maria actually won the Ballon d'Or. Manchester did this again in Bruno Fernandes' contract. Every time the Portuguese player ended up in the BDO top 3, United have to pay $6.5 million to Sporting Lisbon. Well, I guess they're already getting worried over at Old Trafford.